intact either. I mean, it's not enough to cause any trouble. So thanks for that. That helped out a lot. I got the whole thing. And let's see, no swap meet for me either. I wasn't going out in that rain. I think, did we get 3 inches up over the weekend? Something like that. It was pretty rainy here. And I think I heard Jeff KK6IRZ break in there. I thought you were just trying to get on the whistle. Did you have something you wanted to mention? Go ahead, Jeff.
Oh, thanks for grabbing me. But no, actually, I had let Skip know that I might disappear in order to go pick up the wife, and I'm sure that while I was gone, he probably called me at least once. So I was just trying to let him know I was back. That's all.
Okay. Yeah, you're on the list, of course. So we will get you pretty soon. All right. Well, let's see. It's 8 o'clock, and... this is the Wednesday Amplitude Modulation International Net, or AMI, and we strive to promote the restoration, preservation, and enjoyment of AM equipment, including transmitters, receivers, and assorted vintage AM gear. Anyone using this equipment is welcome, including a modern radio, as long as you can make AM on it. And you don't need to be a member to join the net, but you can join and get a certificate with your own personal ID number. If you'd like a membership, go to our AMI website, www.aminternational.club, and fill out the membership form and pay the $5 fee. You can also send a self-address to John McGrath, N9AMI, P.O. Box 1422, Silver Springs, Nevada, 89429. And John, N9AMI is good on QRZ as well. So tonight you're listening to WJ6W Dave. My AMI number is 1235, and I'm located in Tarzana, California, in the San Fernando Valley. And my equipment tonight is a Collins 20V2 broadcast transmitter and going to an inverted B antenna up in the trees in the hill outside the house and listening on an ICOM's, 7610. ICOM 7610. So we have a West Coast website, too. It's www.westcoastami.com. You can visit and enjoy some pictures and sound, audio and various things there. And you can also contribute if you want. So when I call you, please share your call, name, and make and model of equipment. If you have any buy or sale items, please list them. And let me know if you want to stay for the informal roundtable immediately following this net. So now let's take a minute or so for a tune-up, and then we'll get started. Go ahead. This is WJ6W.
Matthew's trying to check in. November 4, Delta, Lima, Alpha.
Okay, yeah, I didn't hear Matthew. I think I heard a November 2, November something. Would you give me a call a couple times? Go ahead. Okay, November 2, November Juliet Zulu. Are you in the West Coast area? Are you out east or something? Go ahead. Okay, well, very good. Can you stick around half of the net? Well, this is the first time. Matt, and you're near Phoenix. Can you stick around for the net? Okay, I think that was an affirmative. Maybe by the time we get to you, it'll be a little while. Maybe conditions will be a little better, and we'll hear you a little more clearly. But the 25 watts is making it to Los Angeles. Just making it to Los Angeles. So, very good. Nice to meet you. Okay, let's get started with the net. I'll go by fours, and I'll start with shift K6LGL, and then it goes to Larry, W6WUH. Larry, please turn it to Ron, KD6VWS, and Ron, turn it to Jeff, KK6IRZ, and then you can turn it back. Go ahead, Skip, K6LGL, W96M.
Well, thank you very much, Dave. Appreciate it. WJ6W. And West Coast AMI Net. K6IOGL. Skip in Santa Monica. Good evening to... And to... MJZ. And, of course, Master M4DLA. Happy to see you there. Okay, nice day down this evening down in Santa Monica. This is 6 6 LGL. Okay, I'm still running my Benton Harbor. Not exactly heavy metal, but it's nice metal. So, the Dixie 100. I'm sure that they hear better from there from, from Arizona. It's been a while, so my pleasure. So, nothing else in particular to report. Larry, thank you for a little help there on the 400 parts at 5 points plug, 5-pin connector. Well, as if I have a shell, but I don't have the connector itself, so that would make it a little bit easier. And I'll enter time my modulator to the 500. And those 8011s driven by 606s will put out enough power to give a little bit of audio there, so the big one. Okay, homebrew antenna. That's about a generation old, and I'm 104 with a few minor acoustic adjustments. So that's the story there, and my AMI number is 1326, 1326. It's easy to remember. 13 and 213. So, thanks, Ron, for doing the relay on that, and I know how it is, locally. It's a little hard to hear. So, over to you, Larry, and wonder what you will be on. Because even on low power, you have a pretty good signal here in Santa Monica. W6WUH, up there on Occidental, stage 6.
Alrighty, K6LGL in the group. W6WUH. Dave, thanks for taking the net. Do you have some copy with this, or should I go to high power?
Well, I'm copying you on the KFS from all the way down here, but copyable.
Alright, we'll go to high power then. What the heck. Wanted to run the van cup tonight, but I need you to hear me. W6WUH, Larry in Oxford, Delta, AMI number is 800. G76, this is the FT450 driving the SB200. Let's see, that's a 2060A antenna tuner, 450 open wire line to 80 meter dipole being used as an all band antenna. That's the situation here. I'll try to stick around for the roundtable. If my wife comes home early for choir, I might not be here, but I'll try. And I do have something for the swap when we get to that. That's about the story of that. W6WUH, go ahead.
Okay, Larry. W6WUH. Yeah, good signal down here. Both wolves in the Joshua tree. The whole top on the way. Okay. Yeah, this is one in Joshua tree. And,
like a pretty good list. But there's got to be 15 or 17 on there, so that's a good nice mix. And we'll see if the conditions can keep things going for us. So I'm operating a Bourbon DJS 750 transmitter, which is a general coverage transmitter from 1.8 to 30 megahertz. A tube-style modulated rig. And built in 1992 or so, and on from the east coast and moved out to the west coast. My antenna is an 80-meter dipole, open wire line down to a balance tuner. I'm probably running about 300 watts of stereo right at the moment. And just an electric condenser microphone and a little bit of touching of processing with a EQ at the end of it to try to keep things sounding somewhat smooth. My AMI number is 1809. I'm going to try to stay around for the round table afterwards, but I'm not sure if I'm going to make it. The wife has been eyeballing me a little bit, but I usually tell her Wednesday night is my time. We'll see how that all works out. And I don't have anything to sell. Other than that, things have been going all okay. Been having some fun up on 40 meters, although it's been quiet here for the last few days, probably because of the Easter gatherings and not as many people on. But the band has been pretty nice, and it's been fun. So back over to you, Dave. WJ6W with the Wednesday night AMI net. This is KK6IRZ, Jeff in Chino, California.
All right, Jeff, very good. Well, you're the strongest one in that group tonight, but everyone was pretty good.
Larry, when we first came on, we were just a little uncomfortably noisy here, so I just switched over to TFS, and you were full planning my kind of road. When you went to high power, though, you were very good. Now, Larry, you had something to swap, so go ahead and list that. You can list it when you kick in, but go ahead.
Okay, thank you, Dave. On the 40-meter swap net, 2 or 3 weeks ago, I took a listing from Kilo Charlie 7 Hotel Kilo Uniform. That's Marshall up in Auburn. Marshall has got a Johnson Viking 500. You know, those are really lovely transmitter, 4400 modulated by a pair of 811As with a separate power supply modulator, so it just takes up as much space on the bench as a Valiant would, but a beautiful transmitter. He says he's recapped the power supply. It's blowing a low voltage fuse, so it's still got some problem, but it's available for best offer. I think something like around $500 would buy it. I will rescue it to keep it from going to the landfill, but I'd really prefer somebody else buy it because I've got two Globe Kings here already waiting to be worked on. So his phone number, 530-268-3148. For those of you who may not know, Auburn is up in the foothills above Sacramento, Sacramento. 530-268-3148. Thanks, Dave. WJ6W6WUH.
Okay, Larry, very good. Well, that's a nice first thing. Yeah,
it's a nice thing to get into somebody's hands. And I think I got that offered. I knew you were very interested. I heard your interest on the 40-meter net. I'll just repeat that. There's a KC7HKU, I think is the call. His name is Marshall in Auburn, California. He has a Johnson Viking 500 that he recapped, but it's still apparently blowing the fuse. I forget what you said. Before you said it, the fuse blows. But anyway, he's asking best offer on it. Larry thinks 500 would be fair. The phone number is 530-268-3148. So, any sales on that, Larry? Is that okay?
Yeah, I think he'll sell it for that. I think that's a steal. I think that's a lot less than it's really worth.
Yeah, okay, very good. All right, let's see. And who wants to get on the AMI net tonight, give us your call now.
Whiskey 7 Tango, Mike Delta.
I don't know if it's possible, it was masculine. Did anyone talk to that call? Whiskey 7, Tango, Mike, Delta.
Okay, Tango, Mike, Delta is pretty rough here. Let me see if they come up better on the internet, but please give me a call on Tango, Mike, Delta. Go ahead.
Relay.
Whiskey 7.
Whiskey 7, Tango Mike Delta.
This is WWMD up here in northern Idaho. Do I have it there? Over.
Yeah, stand by. You're checked in on the net. Stand by. You'll get a call.
That's on the KFS. Again, number 7, Tango Mike Delta in Idaho, is that correct?
Hey, QSL Dave, you got it correct.
Okay, very good. We're on the list and we'll pick you up later. So stick around. So, continuing on with the next four in our group, we have KW1NG10. And George, W6YEC. And then off to another George, W86HTX. And George, MWAIFLY. That's John, and then back to me. 1NG, WJ6W. Are you going to stick around for the
Go. That's amazing. Now you're just loud and clear.
Maybe it's my radio. Okay, well, let's continue on with George. W6YEC, go ahead.
W6YEC. No, I don't think it's your radio. He was down, and I was doing really good. But then he popped up, and conditions just changed in his favor. Or our favor. Anyway, I think he got it there, Dave. Very good.
Good morning, buddy, tonight. Thanks for taking the net, my friend.
I was enjoying it when you run the net. I was just very stupid.
And, well, we're running the same old tonight. The vintage here, the Ranger 2, and driving a Sugar Baker 220, and putting out about 350 watts of stereo or something like that. And AKG microphone from a Behringer, and that's the audio side of things.
And listening on a Hamlin HQ 110 Alpha.
But also, using the big Corba came in that
we're enjoying listening to. Long Norm Johnson.
And it was given to me, and I really appreciate it.
Norm did some major modifications on it.
Really
changed the signal to noise ratio.
Wow.
It's quiet. Very nice.
Very nice to listen to.
So,
speaking of the 7584, I'm trying to help a friend of mine who has some medical issues. He's trying to get rid of some gear.
We sold some of it. We're going to deal with it on Wednesday. But I'm going to be bringing home a 7584 in very, very nice condition. And as I remember, the 4-to-1 dial and all of the filters in it, CW sideband and AM. So if anybody would be interested in an A4, we'll pass it along and make a good deal and give it a holler. And I'll run by the offer with him, and I'm sure it'll be fine if it's not a reason. Anyway, trying to raise medical needs. So, and there's some other things too. The SA-26A tuner that he kicks makes, which is such a fine tuner. That'll be available also, I believe. And I don't think anybody snapped that up yet.
But there's a whole bunch of other things too.
And we'll get into it in the time comes. That's what we get them used to. And but most of the qualities are the same.
So, thank you for running the net, going around table. And everybody sounded pretty good, giving some good things for all of that.
So that's back to you, WJ6WW6YEC here in Lemon Grove.
Okay, George. Yeah, I got it. I'm sorry about earlier, but obviously, Chris and George, as a crane has unfortunately sad medical needs and needs to sell some equipment. He has a very nice 7584 tuner. And he's got SA-26A tuner and maybe some other stuff. Did you want to give your number, George?
George, you called me at 619-277-6043.
Okay, George's number is 619-277-6043. Oh, I'm sure a lot of us already have that number. Okay. Let's continue on. It goes to George again.
Another George.
Have nothing to swap, have no needs right now. and will not be able to get around to Vancouver. Anyhow, I'm going to John, and I took L-Y, John, and let's hurry there, ready?
Okay, thanks, George, and good evening, everybody. This is John, AI-6LY, Alpha India, on the front end there, up in Scotts Valley, California, north of Santa Cruz and the Monterey Bay. And hearing everybody mostly pretty good. A couple of times it was borderline, maybe thinking about turning on KSS, but I didn't do it. So the weaker signals, you know, are getting clobbered by the southern moss, and the stronger signals are coming through just fine. So good to hear everybody. Hope you're all doing well. AMI number 1773, and running the Collins gear again tonight, C32V2, with a little help from the amplifier, and listening on the 75A1. Antennas, the 80-meter dipole hanging from the tower, and the microphone is the D104. Just swapping around table, and thanks for taking the net there, Dave, and Ron, thanks for getting, I think Ron got me in, Ron or Skip getting me in on the early. Thanks, guys, appreciate it, always good to hear y'all. Stay well. AI-6LY, back to WJ-6W.
Okay, and if I miss it, will I stick around for round table?
No swap and no round table, thanks.
Yeah, okay, very good. AI-6LY, John, very good. The 32V2 sounds very nice. And George, HCX, grabbed the 5000 and is serving its backup purposes. Nice little receiver, I always like those. And let's see, let's continue on with the next four then. Next, Ron, ATA, my name. Ron, turn it to WD60GJ, that's Dennis. And Dennis, turn it to KF6IYC, that's Larry. Larry, please turn it to Bob, A9AIE, and back to me, Bob. K6NTA, go ahead.
Okay, Dave, thanks. Yeah. WJ6W, K6ZT. Yeah, WJ6W, K6ZTA. All right, yeah, the handle here is Juan Victor Oscar November. I'm in Lebanon Hills, and my AMI number 1757. And we're running the Viking 2. 100 watts of carrier right now. And the receiver is the FX96. And I have a 2060 antenna tuner tuning up my 80 meter inverted V. Tuning it on so that we can make it work here on 75. Right at the limit. It's an antenna down at 3550 or so. So it's not aero friendly here at 3870. Anyway, no on the swap, no on the round table. Everything else is going good here. And carry on there, Dave. Thanks very much. And yeah, thanks a lot, Skip, and also Ron for helping out there. Okay, WJ6W, K6ZTA.
Okay, Ron, very good. One next to WB60DJ, go ahead.
Dennis out here about 20 miles northeast.
We knew that. We got a good deal of rigging down here.
Yeah.
Let's see if there's anyone else who wants to be on the list. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 left on the list. Anyone else who wants to get on the list? Come now.
Is that correct?
So let's continue on. KF6XYZ, and then please turn it to our friend NY6LZ, and then we'll go out to Arizona for a couple. We'll go to George. And then it goes to NY7RH, and then back to you. KF6XYZ, WJ6LZ.
All right, Dave, KF6FID, Steve in Long Beach. You know, if you round off the bottom of the V, it becomes a U, so it's quite understandable. Let's see, AMI-1708, CCA AM-1000, D transmitter, and propagation's just fine. I have not used KFS to hear anyone, and I've been a little ways across the room on the workbench checking voltages on a transceiver. You know, you pull the tube out. I know you're not supposed to pull the tube out. You're supposed to leave the tube in and check the voltages underneath, but no, forget it. So I pull each tube out and check voltage, and I guess if it's wrong, I plug the tube back in and make sure it's wrong. Just enjoying the net, hearing everyone. But Larry, I couldn't concentrate on the chart and the readings because it was blasting out of the speaker, and I didn't want to go across the room and turn it down. Larry, it's a really powerful, that Ranger with the amplifier, but blasting away is clear too. It's not fuzzy or anything. It's just perfectly readable. So that's a real go-getter. No swap, no round table, and see, I'm supposed to turn it. Jay, in my sitel, I'm wondering. It was raining cats and dogs on Saturday, but somehow I can just see it snowing and hailing with 50-mile-an-hour winds, and you'll be down there at the swap meet at TRW behind your table. I'm wondering if he made it out there on Saturday. I didn't go. NY6L to take it in the net. KF6SYD.
Hello there, Steve. Well, NY6LJ here in Hesperia.
Well, that's a very, very good analogy. No, I didn't like him because it was not safe to go down the hill. We have flurries here, high winds, and a lot of rain. So I just hunkered down and let the doggies and the rain turned into snow flurries, and I watched those fluffy things come down. They didn't stick, but it definitely came down for quite a while here. And it was 33 degrees outside, and I just was a comfy 71 degrees in the house, so I just worked on my projects and worked on my boxes and all that stuff. So there you go. Okay. That's it here. Let's see. Yeah, 48, and these are the equipment we got here. Super senior here, but I don't know what the carrier. So peak, well, we're doing about from 900 plus to 1,000.
Okay, W, you need to pick it up. I'm here in shall we say, calm this area in my visit.
Alrighty, NY6L and the AMI net here this evening. This is W8 Victor Golf, George, out here in Oil Valley, Arizona. About 10 miles north of Tucson, the old Pueblo. And hearing everybody pretty good tonight, but I am going back and forth between AFS and the R390.
How do you reckon I'm
doing? I'm a little further east here to the east of things, and picking up a little more of the southern moss. So the radio signals are coming through quite nicely. Dave, you're nice and strong. So is Steve. Jay, I was hearing you pretty well, but some are a little better on AFS. So there you go. But I think with normal conditions, without all the interference, I'd probably be hearing everybody directly here. Running the same equipment as always, pair of 813, homebrew, modulated by a pair. Listening on an R390, not an A, and my antenna's an inverted V up about 40 plus feet, and bed in the center with ladder line down here to a homebrew link tuner. AMI number is 1814, and I have nothing to buy, sell, or swap, but I have been made aware of a fella up in Cerritos. Up there off of 91, he's got quite a bit of gear, older gear that he wants to get rid of. And it is free for the taking, but whoever shows up has to take it all. And he's actually a friend of Jim. Some of you may know Jim here in Tucson, K7 East West East. And Frank, W7YZ, actually talked to the gentleman, and he is legit. We thought about going up and getting some of it, but it's just too far for us Tucson guys, so I thought I'd pass it along. Quite a list here, Dave, but I'll just go through it quickly. Drake MN2700, Heat Kit HG10, a Knight Kit receiver, a Dentron Transmatch, a Globe Chief, a Collins R388, a Viking Adventure, a Collins 51J4, an ICO 720-730 combo, RME 4350 receiver with pre-selector, a couple of HQ110s, a Heat Kit Marauder, some Simpson VFOs, and a Hamilton speaker. Quite a little haul. And whoever gets it has to take it all away. And it's free to anyone who will do that. He's not willing to piecemeal any of it out. And I can give you his number. Frank actually talked to him. He's legit. It's Dave. His name is Dave. And he's at 323-559-7700. 323-559-7700. And his name is Dave. He is a K6 station, but I don't happen to have his call handy. So if anybody's got a trailer, a pickup truck, or wants to get a few guys together, it's quite a load, but he wants it all gone. Anyway, good stuff, too, although I have enough here in my collection. Let's see. We'll not be around for the round table. May listen here a little bit, Dave. So, let's see. It goes up to my neighbor Bob up in Phoenix. NA7RH on the Sweet Tube Special. Here is W8 Victor Golf. Take her away, Bob.
Hey, very good, George. WDG with the I'm hoping I'm being heard a little bit. Pretty much 20 over on KFS, and I'm only about 5 or so over. But anyway, we're hearing the whiny sidebanders from South Texas. They're making all kinds of noise, and on one side, and on the other side is Woodlawn. Anyway, KYB, whatever it's called, is at the moment. Anyway, both sides, this side, making it a little hard to copy here in the Scottsdale area, but it's still persevering. Most everyone has been just fine copyable through the noise there this evening. Anyway, EMI 15.3, nothing to say. No round table tonight. That's all we got, and totally overwhelming me right now. WJ6 took W, I'll get it right. That's you, Dave, the WJ6W, NA7I.
Okay, you got it, Bob.
Very good.
Yeah, a lot of competition, QRM, there tonight. So it's kind of rough copy, Bob. So I hope I didn't miss anything. It's important, but I just couldn't pull a lot of it out. And one of the first times ever, I can't really copy everything. Anyway, let's see, George, W. Victor Golf,
out there in Arizona.
No, there's a Pam in Cerritos here in L.A. area, Dave, who has a bunch of stuff that he wants to get rid of. He doesn't want to break it up. He wants it all to go. And you need to bring a truck, I guess. I copied down a few things. There's a whole bunch of stuff. MM2700 tuner, HG10, oscillator, a Dentron, I don't know if it was an amp or a tuner. RC88, 51J4, ISO 727, RME4350, 210 receiver, a bunch of other stuff. So if you're interested, Dave's number is 323-559-7700. 323-559-7700. Now this has turned into the swap net tonight, hasn't it? Okay, we have four more on the list. Let's go through those. And I may have some trouble with some guys, so listen up if anyone can help me out. We have N2, NJZ, Matt in Phoenix on 25 watts. And Matt, turn it to Matthew. Matthew to Matthew, I guess. N4DLA, that's N4DLA, and I don't know if I'll copy Matthew. Probably on KFX, so I will. Then Matthew, turn it to W7TMD, W7TMD, Mike Delta in Idaho. And then when you're done, please turn it to KJ6H Red. And then it goes back to me. So, Matt and Phoenix, go ahead. N2, NJZ, WJ6W. I'm not sure.
Lancer in Phoenix.
Unfortunately, I really couldn't pop it up
there. I'm going to be on my second scope and notice when you drop the carrier. So, anyway, if you have an amplifier, it sure help out.
Okay, let's see if we can go to Matthew up north. N4DLA, it's your turn. Go ahead. WJ67.
Okay.
Try for Idaho. Next. W7CMD. W7CMD. It's your turn. Go ahead. This is WJ67.
Okay, I think you turned it over to me here. AMI number is 17801. And sorry, it took me a minute. I had to hit the mute on the SDR. Very hard copy up here in northern Idaho, where it is 42 degrees and expecting rain. Using a Johnson 500 and a National NC300 for a receiver into a Palstar HF Auto and a 106 meter loop antenna at about 80 feet or so. Very hard copy up here. I heard some of the stronger signals, but the weaker ones was just too many static crashes. We're expecting some lightning at some point down south of us. So very hard copy. So I'll turn it back over to the net. No swap or round table. And I guess it goes to KJ6 Hotel Zulu. And thanks for giving me the net, W7TMD.
Oh, look at this. I think I heard it coming over to me.
This is John. This is Hotel Zulu.
Hey, man. This is my name is John. Hotel Zulu. This is my first time
ever. Riverside and
Just don't have the amp wire stuff. It's nice at the moment. So,
that's the deep end here. If I didn't mention that, I had to work in the Riverside, California.
Okay, John, very good. Yeah, and you're at the tail end of the list, so turning it back to me is okay. Well, from the other side, we're 75 watts, so except for QSD, you're doing pretty well, a pretty comfortable, except when you fade it down, it's kind of rough. So an amplifier would help out a lot, and I'm glad you're working on that, so very good. And let's see, Tom in Idaho, copies you just fine on KFX, but not locally. I don't believe that I copied very well locally. I didn't, once I went to KFX, it was pretty good, so I left it there. So, with that, let me take one final check to see if anyone else wants to check in late here for the AMI net. Come now. Okay, 4703Y, is there somebody else? No, I guess not. KB7OCY out there in Arizona, too. Go ahead and take one. This is WJ6W, Dave in Tarzana.
Hey, Dave, W6JW, how you doing tonight? KB7OCY here in Central Arizona. I'm getting you pretty good, and at the same time, all of a sudden the kick started coming in real strong. So, bear with me. I hope you can hear me A-okay. Here's a Kenwood 590 into a homebrew two-holer, 2FX250 amplifier running about 300 watt carrier from this vertical antenna. And I'm receiving you equally as well on the beverage as I am on the vertical. I have nothing to for sale, or I don't no wants or needs to swap or anything like that. So thank you for taking me in. Dave, back over to you, KB7OCY. Thank you.
Okay, very good. I think it's Hank here, Hank, something like that. KB7OCY. I should know your name. You've been in and out for years here on the AMI net. You were 10 over at times, and then you kind of got down into the noise a bit. So overall, pretty good. So with that, we'll close the AMI net for tonight. And this is what I have for a round table. I have four stations. We have Skip, K6LZ, of course. And then Larry, W6WUH, W6WUH, after Skip. And then Larry, turn it to Jeff, KK6IRZ, Jeff, KK6IRZ, and then Jeff, turn it to J, NY6L. And I'm going to drop out, I think, so J, when you're done, turn it back to Skip. So, good night, everybody, and I'll turn it over to Skip here. K6LGL, WJ6W.